What's going on, guys? Balkan Architect here, and in today's video we're talking about Noteblock Schedules inside of Revit. So you might be thinking, well, what is this Noteblock Schedule and how do I use it? Well, a Noteblock Schedule allows you to kind of keep track of your notes on a Revit model. So for example, if you were just placing text notes, so just going to the text tool and placing a text in terms of like making notes on your views, well, you can't really keep track of that. It's only visible in the individual views themselves. Now, by using a Noteblock Schedule, you have these little families which you place as notes, and they can be just simple numbers. And then when you select that note family, you can write in the properties panel, you can write whatever you want as a note. And then you have a schedule that kind of keeps track of all of those notes that you have on your model. So I'm just going to be showing you how to do this. So it's a kind of a superior way of keeping notes or placing notes on your Revit models. Now, before we jump into Revit, I would just like to take a moment to ask you to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up just below this video in the description and then also up in the cards above. There you can find all of my Revit courses. And if you're interested, for example, in schedules, I have an entire course on Revit schedules, pretty much everything you need to know when it comes to schedules in Revit. Apart from that, I cover numerous different topics ranging from beginner to intermediate as well as advanced level users, so there is something there for everybody. Now also there you can find some of my ready to go Revit templates, so custom Revit templates. You can find some really high quality Revit families. Actually, recently we have added some more families, so make sure to check that out. And also there is a unique plugin which you can find there as well. Okay, so now without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. So here we are in Revit, and as you can see, I'm using this office building project. So this is just one of my courses. In one of the courses, I show you how to design this whole model and produce all of the project documentation and so on and so forth. Now let's create a Noteblock schedule. So first, what we need is a note family. So for the notes, we're not going to be using simple text. We're going to be creating a specific family for that. So you want to go here to the file menu, you want to go to new, and then you want to go to family. Now for the family, I'm just going to search for annotations, and then here we're going to have a metric generic annotation, and this is what I'm going to be using. So then you want to hit open, and that's going to open up that family. Here we have some text. I'm just going to get rid of that text, and now for this I'm just going to go to create and then go to label. So you just want to place one label, and you can just click here and place it just in the center of that view. So for this we have to now create some parameters for this label. Now we actually need two parameters, one for the number of the label and the second one for the actual text of the note. So let's go here to new, and then for this is just going to be discipline common. The type of parameter is going to be text, and then here for the name I'm just going to call this one number. Okay, make sure it's an instance parameter, click OK, and then it's going to appear there. Then let's create a new one. So this one is going to be text. Again, make sure it's a text parameter. Make sure it's instance. Click OK, and there we go. So once we have these two parameters, one of them should be placed on the screen, and that should be the number parameter. So you just want to click here to add parameters to the label. So this means when you place the family itself, this number, I'm missing an M. Okay, let's add it to that. Okay, so when I place this number parameter, it's going to kind of display the number. So let's go to the sample value and then just add a couple of zeros. That's okay. No prefix, no suffix. I don't think it's necessary. And then for the text, that should only appear in the properties panel. So that's not going to be displayed on the label itself. Then you can just hit apply. Okay, and this is what we have. Hit the escape key a couple of times. Now for this label, you will see this is a 3mm label. If you don't like that, you can go into edit type, and then you can duplicate this one, create a different one, perhaps smaller or larger text for the number. I'm perfectly fine with 00, so I'm just going to leave it as is, and then I'm just going to make this a bit smaller. So in this case, we're not going to be going past like 99 notes, so I'm just going to leave two zeros. Obviously, if you have hundreds of them or thousands, you would add more zeros, so it's a little bit bigger. Anyways, finally, just to add a little bit more graphics, let's add a circle around this thing, so just like that. Okay, looks fairly simple and straightforward. Also for the label, you can set up the alignment horizontally and vertically. I like to leave it at center in the middle, so it goes from the center out. So if it's just displaying one, it's not going to be aligned anywhere, it's just going to be in the center. So that's why, or just single digits. Okay, so once we have all of this done, we can go ahead and save this family. So I can just save it on my desktop, call this one my note family, hit save, okay, and then I can load that into the project and close it. So once we're here in the project, okay, let's go back to the project. Okay, so once we're in the project, now we want to place those notes. So you want to go here to annotate, you want to go to symbol, because this will appear as a symbol, and there we have our note family, and then you can place it wherever you want. So I can just come in here, place it here, and as you can see, it's just going to appear like this. It's not going to have a number nor text. So I can say this is my label one, or my note one. And then I can also add a leader here. So I can say, okay, I want it to be pointing at this wall. And then I can say, okay, so I can just select this. And then here, as you can see, we have text, and I can say, make this a brick wall. Okay, so now I have added my first label. So as you can see, the text doesn't appear anywhere, but it's there in the properties panel. Then I can add a few more. So for example, I can add one here. No, let's go here. Then I can see this is my label two. I can add a leader that points to this window, and then I can say, make this a larger window. Hit enter to enter that text. There we go. And then let's add just a final one. So let's go again to annotate, go to symbol, place it here. And then this will be the third one. So you can see how little space this is taking up. So imagine if you have tons of notes, you obviously don't want to have this entire text appearing over here, because it would take too much space. So that's the beauty of this approach. And then I can say, go to here, and then I can write, do we really need this column? This is a very architect note. Okay, so once we have these notes, now in order to display them or to view them in a single place, that's with a Noteblock schedule. So what you want to do is go to the View tab, and then here you want to find Schedules, expand the drop menu, and find a Noteblock. So here you want to find that note family. So as you can see, it's just going to give you all of these symbol families that we have loaded in. Obviously, we want to use the note family that we have created. And then here you have the all of your parameters. So here I just want to have the number, and then I want to have the text, and that's perfectly fine. Click OK, and then it's just going to create that schedule over here. And then we can probably expand that. There we go. So as you can see, you have one schedule that's kind of displaying everything from the notes. So now if we go down here, and let's see, do we have this on a sheet? We probably do not. Okay, let's get rid of this. Let's place this view on our sheet. So that's the detailed one. Let's give it a second. Okay, so we have this floor plan, and then what I can do is I can just find that schedule, so this note block schedule, and then I can place it there. So as you can see, we have all of the information about the notes that are in the model. It's displaying that here. So it's a lot cleaner and organized way of displaying notes. So you can either kind of look through the model, and then you can say, okay, what is this number one talking about this wall? And then you can find it. Oh, make this a brick wall. And then you can find, do we really need this column? And then you can be like, okay, which column? And then you can search for it and you can say, okay, that's this column. And that's how the Noteblock schedules work. Now, I actually have a video where I show you how you can add a checkbox to these schedules. So it's basically, it's going to give you a little additional field with a checkbox where you can kind of follow, did you fix whatever was necessary to be fixed in the notes. So I do have that video. I'm going to link it up in the cards above so you can check it out if you want to see that. And also, if you want to get my Revit project files, like this big office building that we have here, or any of my other Revit project files, well, I actually have them all on my Patreon page. So I'm going to include that just in the description of this video below and then also up in the cards above. So if you're interested in my Revit models, you can find them there. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.